सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ सेल्स, सेम सिचुएशन एक्जैक्टली यू डन क्लास 10th फॉर रेजिस्टेंस कॉम्बिनेशन इन सीरीज इन पैरेलल. नाउ फर्स्टली आई विल से राइट ग्रुपिंग ऑफ सेल्स. राइट ग्रुपिंग यू विल से इफ द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द सेल इज लाइक दिस, पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव. I say this cell is having EMF E1 internal resistance R1. This is having EMF E2 internal resistance R2. Okay, so you will say when each cell in series deliver the current in same direction, then you will say it is the red grouping. So I am writing the definition also. You will say when each cell in series deliver the current in same direction, then you will say it is the right grouping of cell. So if I ask you what is the net EMF or equivalent EMF, you will say me it is E1 plus E2. Okay. And if I ask you what is the net resistance of these two cells in combination, you will say R1 plus R2. Okay, then I will discuss with you wrong grouping of cells also. In some numericals we get such situation. Here what will happen, suppose you say this is the first cell and it is connected to the second cell like this. I think some of you are getting negative and negatives, there is chance of short circuiting. Here EMF E1 R1, here EMF E2 and resistance is R2. Now if I ask you what is the net EMF of the circuit, if E1 is more than E2, then I will say E1 minus E2, and if E2 is more than E1, I will say it is E2 minus E1. So again I am telling you, if I assume E1 is greater than E2, then E equivalent can be written as E1 minus E2, or if E2 is more than E1, you will say E2 minus E1. Now what is the R equivalent? Because both are connected in series, so you will say it is R1 plus R2. I hope it is clear to all of you. No problem. In this way, we will use in the circuit. So now we are going for the series combination in detail. So suppose I assume that there are n cells. Each of them are having same EMF and same internal resistance. And they are connected in right grouping, or you can see in same polarity to any external resistance like this. Now I say there are n cells in series, each cell is having EMF E and internal resistance R, and it is connected to external resistance like this. Now if I ask you what is the net EMF of the circuit, you will say they are connected in same polarity, so you will say it should be NE. Now what is the equivalent resistance of the circuit? If I ask you write the equivalent resistance, you will say external resistance plus net internal resistance. And I think I have discussed you in the last slide that it doesn't matter the cells are connected in same polarity or wrong polarity, resistance will be always add up. Okay, now can you tell me what is the net current in the circuit? I equal to, you will write the net EMF and you will write the net resistance of the circuit. Is it clear to all of you? Now, if I say the situation is such that capital R is less than small r. Okay, suppose you say that sum of the net internal resistance is very high compared to the external resistance, or external resistance is negligible. In that situation, you will say I can be written as, you apply in this formula, you will say NE upon NR, because capital R is negligible, what you get, I equal to E by R. So what we observe, this is the current in the circuit due to only one cell. It is visible to all of you. I hope it is clear to all of you. Therefore, series grouping of the cell will be used in such a case when external resistance is very small in comparison to internal resistance. Again, I will correct it. If there is an umbilical in which external resistance is very less compared to the total internal resistance, then we will say series circuit is of no use. So you will say this type of the combination is not used for series connection. Similarly, if I say R is greater than small nr, you will write I equal to N E upon R, and this is the maximum current. This time the current in the resistance is N times current due to one cell. So we say in series grouping of cell, this is the useful situation. Okay, no problem in it. So again, I am showing you this in the slide. Cells are connected in series when they are joined end to end, so that same quantity of the electricity must flow through each cell. Suppose you say these are the number of cells, current I is flowing, that we have discussed. This is the total current. Okay, then R is less than NR, we have discussed, or NR is less than R, we have discussed. When internal resistance is negligible in comparison to external resistance, then the cells are connected in series to get maximum current. Again, I am showing you. If external resistance is more than internal resistance, then you will say current in the circuit is N times that of the circuit current due to single cell. And if external resistance is less, current in the circuit is equal to that of single short circuited cell, because E by R is the short circuit current, that you people know very well, because main current is known as I equal to E upon R plus R. R is negligible, you will say it is short circuit current. So when you will use the series combination in this situation, when external resistance is high compared to internal resistance. Okay, now we will discuss the cells in parallel combination.